Hello to all my third year civil engineering students. Since due to this coronavirus outbreak, further lectures will be conducted online. So in the transportation engineering syllabus, the last previous lecture was related to Windrose diagram that we completed. That is Windrose type 1 and Windrose type 2 and how to plot those Windrose diagram. The next topic of transportation engineering related to airport engineering is the runway length. Now here we have numericals related to runway length, that how based on the various factors you are supposed to decide the length of the runway. Before that, we have this concept which is called the basic runway length. Now what do you mean by basic runway length is when you consider those factors as standard, say temperature is standard, say elevation is standard, there is no slope, there is no wind, all those when you consider as a standard, so that runway length what you get is the basic runway length. Then according to the various factors like elevation, temperature, we'll have to correct those runway length. Okay, so here it is given that it is the length of the runway under the following assumed condition of the airport. The airport elevation is at sea level. The temperature of the airport is standard, which is 15 degrees Celsius. Runway is leveled in the longitudinal direction, that is it has no slope. No wind is blowing on runway. Aircraft is loaded to its full loading capacity. There is no wind blowing on the runway to the destination. Like till it reaches the destination, there is no wind blowing. And en route temperature, throughout the route, the temperature is also standard. Now, before deciding the basic runway length, there are few cases which you are supposed to go through it. That is normal landing case, normal takeoff case, engine failure case. Then there is a note which says that for jet engine, all three cases are considered, while for piston engine, the first, that is normal landing case, and third, that is engine failure case, are considered. This is because the normal takeoff case does not have that much effect for piston engine aircraft in deciding the length of the runway. The cases which works out the longest runway length is finally adopted. Now we'll go through the cases. The first is the normal landing case. Now you can see this diagram where the runway is shown, and this is the 60% landing distance, and total runway is the total landing distance. Okay, though when do you say that the case is a normal landing case? A normal landing case requires that an aircraft should come to a stop within 60% of the landing distance. Throughout landing distance, and 60% of the landing distance it should cover before taking a stop in the runway. On the runway, the runway of full strength pavement is provided for the entire landing distance, of course. Now this is a normal landing case where 60% of the distance is covered for the aircraft to come to the stop on the runway. Then you have a normal takeoff case. What does it say? The normal takeoff case requires a clear way, which is an area beyond the runway and is in alignment with the center line of runway. The width of the clear way is not less than 150 meter and is kept free from obstructions. The clear way ground area or any object on it should not project a plane inclined upward at a slope of 1.25% from the runway end. Now we'll go through the diagram. Now first see this diagram. What we are talking about in the theory is this clear way, the runway, and beyond which along the same alignment is arranged a clear way. Now clear way does not have to be paved. Runway is paved. The width is given as minimum of 150 meter, and in the theory it was given that there has to be no obstructions. Correct? It has to be kept free from obstructions. Okay. Now when you say normal takeoff case, takeoff, or you say lift off. Okay. So this is your runway area, longitudinal section is showing. Okay, now how do you define the clear way? Runway, lift off distance, which is mostly 40% of the total runway length, 115% of lift off distance is what is till this, and distance till which the aircraft takes takeoff and reaches 10.5 meter height. Okay, this is this distance to 10.5 meter height, and clear way is still this distance where it is 115% of distance to 10.5 meter height takeoff distance. Okay, that is 115% of this. Okay, then here it is given clear way is less than half of this distance. That is this whole distance, okay, this particular clear way from runway to this end is the clear way. Okay, this you can see the longitudinal section of this view. Okay, so from here to here it is a clear way, and this clear way is less than equal to half of this particular distance. Okay, so this is how the clear way is located over the beyond the runway. Now the third case is engine failure case. Now whenever after starting the engine, if at all there is failure in the engine, it has to come to a stop. Okay, so the engine failure case may require either a clear way or a stop way or both. Okay, the clear way as already discussed, then what is stop way? We'll discuss it. Stop way is an area beyond the runway and centrally located in alignment with the center line of the runway. Stop way is used for decelerating the aircraft and bringing it to stop during the aborted takeoff. Okay, when it takes off and then if there is an engine failure, it has to decelerate and come to stop over the runway. If the engine has failed at a speed less than the designated engine failure speed, the pilot decelerates the aircraft and makes use of stop way. Okay, if however the engine fails at a speed higher than the designated speed, there is no other option to the pilot except to continue the takeoff. The pilot may later take a turn in the turning zone and land again for a normal takeoff, obviously. Okay, so what it says that whenever there is an engine failure case, it covers a particular distance on the runway, and then it is observed that there is an engine failure, so it has to decelerate. But when it decelerates, it will cover some distance beyond the runway, and beyond the runway the clear way is not paved once. So beyond the runway, this particular stop way, a paved stop way, is provided whenever there is an engine failure case and the aircraft has to decelerate and come to a stop. So there is an extension, small extension beyond the runway, so this stop way is for that particular distance. Okay, this is your runway. First you will see the plan. Runway, stop way, the color is given, this is because it is a paved one. Okay, and the clear way that we have already discussed. Okay, so and this is the longitudinal section of this particular plan only. Particular runway, stop way, and clear way. Now you know how it is defined. Okay, this clear way from here to here, okay, is particular this distance from runway to this. Okay, this is your clear way, correct? This much. Okay, and your clear way is less than half of this particular distance. Okay, so clear way is less than half of this distance to this distance. Okay, so this is your runway. Okay, engine failure if occurs at a particular point, it has to decelerate and come to stop. Okay, so this stop way is provided. Lift off distance, like discussed previously, and clear way. Accelerated stop distance, okay, when it has to come to a stop, and distance to 10.5 meter height when it takes a takeoff. Okay, like it is like the previous example only, where you are supposed to show the clear way also and stop way also. Therefore, those two diagrams are clubbed, that is showing stop way and showing clear way, where this particular distance was already marked. Okay, how you decide the particular length of that clear way. Okay, then since basic runway length is depends upon this cases, however, like I previously said, there are corrections to this basic runway length, because basic runway length is based on the standard conditions, whereas actual conditions are not the standard conditions. So what are the corrections to be made? First correction to the for elevation, then correction of temperature, and correction of gradient. Now the what it says, the basic runway length is for mean sea level elevation having standard atmospheric conditions, of course, that we have already discussed. Now for any change in elevation, temperature, and gradient for actual site of construction, necessary corrections are to be applied to obtain the length of runway, of course. Then how does elevation affects the length of the runway? The air density reduces as the elevation increases. This I have already told you, As the elevation increases, the air density reduces. This in turn reduces the lift on the wings, of course, because the amount of air density, it is reducing. That is, amount of air is reducing, so it reduces the lift on the wings of the aircraft, and the aircraft requires greater ground speed before it becomes airborne. So it requires larger, it has to cover more distance over the runway so that it becomes airborne. To achieve greater speed, longer length of runway is required. So International Civil Aviation Organization recommends the basic runway length should be increased at the rate of 7% per 300 meter rise in elevation above mean sea level. Okay. So you will be given a particular elevation. You have to see how much it is more than the mean sea level. For individual 300 meter rise, there has to be 7% increase in the basic runway length. I would suggest students to write down this thing. Okay, how much at the rate of 7% per 300 meter rise in elevation, because this is going to be useful by solving the numerical. Correction for temperature. Now, how do you correct the basic runway length in terms of temperature? The rise in airport reference temperature has the same effect as that in increase in elevation. As the temperature increases, the density of air increases, decreases. Sorry. So, density of air, if it decreases, same way it has to cover longer distance over the runway to become airborne. Okay. So, airport reference temperature, how this airport reference temperature is calculated? TA, which is monthly mean of average daily temperature for the hottest month of the year. TM, which is monthly mean of maximum daily temperature for the same month. Okay, monthly mean of average daily temperature. For example, average daily temperature of a particular month, which is the hottest month, say May. So, average daily temperature, say it is 35, 37, 38. Okay, for all those 30, 31 days. So, average of that will be monthly mean of average daily temperature. PM, monthly mean of maximum daily temperature for that particular same month. Say in May, maximum temperature for first day was 40, say it was 38, say 42. So maximum, what was the temperature for a particular day in the hottest month of the year, that average is your TM, monthly mean of maximum daily temperature. Now, the standard, I would suggest you to read the last sentence first. The standard temperature at the airport site can be determined by reducing the standard mean sea level temperature of 15 degrees Celsius at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius per 1000 meter rise in elevation. Please do write down this whole thing. Okay. What it says that the standard temperature at mean sea level is 15 degrees Celsius. But the standard temperature at the airport site would be different. And how it will be different? It will be different because the elevation would be different. The airport will not be at the mean sea level only. It might be with some other elevation. So, with the difference in elevation, you are supposed to change the standard temperature of the airport first. So, how you will change? It is by reducing the mean sea level temperature of 15 degrees Celsius at the rate of 6.5 degrees Celsius per 1000 meter rise in elevation. Okay, so that way you will reduce the standard temperature of the airport. Then you will calculate the reference temperature with this method. You will determine how much the reference temperature is more than the standard temperature, and then you follow this 1% for every 1 degree Celsius rise in airport reference temperature. That is, if my standard temperature by using this comes to say 13 degrees Celsius and reference temperature say it comes to 20 degrees Celsius, so it is more than 7 degrees. So 1% increase in the runway length for every 1 degree rise in airport reference temperature. For say, I would say it was 13 and airport reference temperature is say 20, so 7 degree rise. So, it has to be 7% increase, 7% increase in the runway length. Okay. Now, in further lecture, we will discuss the other things and the numericals also. Okay. Thank you.